Hello and welcome to another SIGSWIN demo. This demo shows how SIGSWIN Turbo IPsec with Virtual Accelerator enables virtual IPsec aggregation for remote users on COTS servers. Benefits include gaining bare metal-like performance in a virtual IPsec gateway, optimizing resource utilization for increased throughput and service scaling, and replacing expensive and proprietary legacy hardware with COTS servers. Let's review the system under test environment. At the compute node console, we see the platform is a one socket machine with an Intel E5-2680 V3 with 12 cores and 24 threads. It has a 2-port Intel 10GE NIC card that will be used for the testing. This system is running CentOS and has Open vSwitch installed. Since this is an OpenStack environment, we will use the Horizon GUI to set up the system under test. For the first scenario, we will create the instance called IPsec Aggregator Linux, provide it with 7 vCPUs, and connect it to the two networks. At the IPsec Aggregator console, we confirm the number of CPUs as 7, and then execute a couple of scripts that will set up the IPsec Aggregator routing configuration and the IPsec configuration. We move to the traffic generator, which will receive and transmit traffic. Note that the traffic encryption happens outside the traffic generator. To simulate 5,000 tunnels, we create 5,000 source addresses using a /16 subnet. Let's start data transmission and see how our first scenario handles 10 gigabits per second of encrypted traffic. On the receive side, the traffic is a low 1.6 gigabits per second. We will start graphing the traffic rate. Obviously, there is a bottleneck in our system under test. Let's check the compute node. It looks moderately busy. On the other hand, we can see that the IPsec aggregator is at 100% utilization. So Turbo IPsec will have the same number of CPUs as the previous machine. We'll go back to the IPsec aggregator console and confirm that Turbo IPsec has 7 CPUs. The configuration is not shown, but it is exactly the same configuration as the last machine. We'll start up the traffic generator and start graphing the traffic rate. Now the rate has jumped up to 4.6 gigabits per second. And you can observe the step up in the graph. Let's check the compute node. It looks tremendously busy. The IPsec aggregator, on the other hand, is at approximately 80% utilization. The bottleneck has now moved to the virtual switch. Virtual Accelerator integration begins by downloading and installing the OpenStack extensions. Once this is done, we download the Virtual Accelerator package and install it. To finish the installation, start Virtual Accelerator and restart OpenStack on the compute node. For this last scenario, Virtual Accelerator is configured with 2 dedicated cores. Now we will spawn a new Turbo IPsec machine with 5 CPUs. We'll start up the traffic generator and start graphing the traffic rate. Now the rate has jumped up to 7.5 gigabits per second, and you can observe the step up in the graph. This is equivalent to 10 gigabits per second of encrypted traffic before processing. Let's check utilization. Both Virtual Accelerator and Turbo IPsec are between 80 to 90% busy. If you look at HTOP on the compute node, you'll see that there are 4 threads that are associated with Virtual Accelerator that are running at 100%. This is as it should be. To summarize the testing, we compared 3 scenarios. In the first scenario, we found the bottleneck to be the Linux virtual machine. It was able to process 2.3 gigabits per second of encrypted traffic. When we added Turbo IPsec, the bottleneck moved to the hypervisor. It did have an increased capacity of 6.1 gigabits per second. Note that in both cases, the platform had no spare resources. When we added Virtual Accelerator, the bottleneck disappeared, and Turbo IPsec was able to process a full 10 gigabit Ethernet link of encrypted traffic, with a dramatic savings in resources that could be used for other virtual machines or increased performance. That is all, and thank you for your patience.